Hello, Wes. This is RaptorTK2, and today you'll get to see exactly what UnitySpice is all about. If you remember from the last video, the card is on your screen now in case you missed that, Ace, I showed you how to get UnitySpice for free, but I didn't get the chance to tell you what it is, and more importantly, what it can do for you. You should hopefully have UnitySpice downloaded, Ace, but in case you haven't, feel free to click the link in the description down below. Now that all that is out of the way, let's get stuck in. Open up an existing Unity project or create a brand new one, Ace. With our project open, navigate to the location you saved UnitySpice, double-click on it, and a dialog box should appear in Unity asking you to import the package. Click Import, and with any luck, the package should import without any problems, Ace. If you do get any compiler errors, specifically because of the UnitySpice import, please don't hesitate to contact me at retrotk2@gmail.com or leave a pleasant comment down below. I'll have to get a better bug reporting system later on down the line, Ace, but for now, this low-tech method will suffice. Okay, great, you've imported UnitySpice into your project and you should hopefully see the Examples folder. The scenes here showcase all the unique usages of the UnitySpice package and will show you how to use all of its features. Now, features are all well and good, Ace, but they really only matter if they offer some sort of benefit. The main benefit of this version of UnitySpice, and indeed the main benefit of all future versions of it, is time. UnitySpice will save you hours of development time, Ace, and with this version we're focusing on debugging, specifically logging. Firstly, let's have a look at the main feature of this release, the logging extensions. Open up the logging example scene and press the play button. And immediately you'll see the log is filled with messages from the example script. Nothing too crazy here, Ace, though I suppose the coloured text in the console might be a bit new to you, since I don't believe we went over that in any of the Unity tutorials thus far. But on the whole, nothing too strange going on here. Ah, but there is, Ace. If we jump into the login example script, you'll see that our log calls aren't at all like anything we've done before. Here we're declaring a string with whatever message we want to log out, and then we're calling an extension method, which then goes and calls the standard Unity debug.log method that we all know and love. I'll be going over extension methods at some point in my C# series, Ace, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on that. If you're a more advanced Unity user, you'll probably be aware of Unity's iLogger interface. This version of UnitySpice doesn't implement this feature, Ace, but future versions will, I promise. Now, while semantically the log extensions are nicer than the standard debug.log methods, you probably won't be getting too excited about them on their own. Ah, but Ace, these extensions allow for greater string formatting. If you take a look at the lines below our simple log calls, you'll see a much more advanced look at this in action. Here I want to log the value of the int I. Now, the standard way to do this would be to use the debug.log method and then add the I value to our string. Not exactly the best way to do this, Ace, and if you've never seen this in C# before, I'll be going over this in the C# series too. The better way to do this is to use the string.format method. This too shall be covered in the C# series. Yes, indeed, there is still a bit to cover in that particular series, Ace. I shall get to it, I promise. So here I can type out debug.log string.format, my int equals open bracket 0 close bracket, and add my object I to the end. This method is better in terms of performances, but don't you find it a little difficult to read? Well, the Spice equivalent is about half the size, uses the same method under the hood, and in my opinion is much easier to read. The only thing that the standard method has over it is the nice green highlighting for the formatted strings, but I'd personally say it's a small price to pay. Now, the other two examples are even more complex, Ace. Here we're logging and formatting just like before, but now we're also adding color to our logs. The standard way to do this is to add color markup tags to your log strings. And with this you can reference the standard Unity colors. That's the red, blue, green, etc. Or you can use the hexadecimal notation instead. Now, these are very basic strings, is just red and white. But look at how complicated these are already. Not nice at all. With the Spice color extension method, we make it all a lot cleaner. I mean, it can still be a little difficult to read, especially if you look at the method on the bottom line. But compared to the alternative, Ace, you have to admit, it's a lot nicer. And that about does it for this version of UnitySpice. The only other thing to comment on is the other string extensions. We've already seen the color extension in action, but there are other examples too. If we pop into the string extensions method scene and click the play button, you'll see we get some logs. If we head into the string extensions example script, you'll see we have extensions for color, format, and format and color. All stuff we've seen so far, yes. But if you look at the top line, you'll see we have a color extension method that will convert a Unity color to an HTML string. This is the exact same extension method I use for the color strings, yes. So the color you pass to the method is then converted to the hex color notation and added to the markup tags. I think that covers just about everything, yes? One final thing is to be careful with the formatted strings. They can be a pain if you don't have the same number of objects as the numbers that are referenced in the string itself. So here I'm deliberately logging out a formatted string, but I'm not passing an object to the log method. If we head back into Unity and run the game, you'll see we're hit with a format exception. This has been a look at the first version of UnitySpice. Be sure to click the link in the description to get your free copy, yes. And that's it. Rate, comment, subscribe, yes, for more game development videos. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with any features you'd like to see in the next version of UnitySpice. Thank you for watching, yes, and I'll see you in the next video.